bit of his time for an item that could hold our...
Fuck, I didn't change over. We're in the middle of the recap. Yeah.
We had our own portable soul jail. So he decided, as a soul, to go inside that one and got himself locked up in that
one.
Just
for one. Fun. Just for fun.
For fun. Exactly. So, yeah, that was an adventure. And then Tess ascended into near godhood.
Oh, yeah, that was a thing.
Yeah,
oh, yeah, that was a thing. A very insignificant event, yeah.
She was like, fuck this mortal life.
She's like, I don't want to have to babysit these fucking children anymore. So she said bye, and she left. And I talked to my fairy inside my brain, you know. The one, you know, the only reason I managed to get out of the soul jail was because of them. I went back to my body thanks to them. Didn't end up getting locked up in there and have a fucking death.
Pretty pog.
And then, remember Jacob was fucking high on so much drugs. Anyway, Jacob became a human, and he's hot apparently. And Swallow doesn't know how to feel about that.
Swallow and Dave is asleep. If he is not aware, by the way. Anyway. Dave was AFK.
Technical difficulties.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, wait. Ulrav was like, sorry, I can't go on with you guys. There's something I must do. Here. So she left, and... Oh, well, we left her. And then she gave you her gem.
The yellow one.
Yeah, because... Mm-hmm. She's like, okay, somebody needs to take this now. And you're like, I want it!
Shine light! Fate calls me in a different direction. I must walk this path by myself. Yada, yada. Nah, no. I must become the voice of the forest. Jungle.
Yeah.
Something. Yeah. Here, take this before you leave.
Yeah, Ulrav set her by that she must go find another path to follow. But you guys all, you know, were like, damn, we need a fucking rest. Came over, found this rooftop here. Got some Z's in, and amid Z's, that's when Jakar turned into a person. You know, using all that sorcery dust that he had swallowed up, breaking some of the bonds. And now you're all awake. And thinking what to do.
Is the sword broken now?
No, the sword's there, but it can now transform into... Let me grab the thing. Oh shit.
That doesn't sound good.
No, we're good.
I love map tools.
No, this is more
so. Biggest fan ever. What would recommend 50 out of 10?
I would like to disagree.
I would like everyone to make an astro account at some point, unless your name is Annie, in which case, fuck you.
Wow, that's a little rude.
Sorry.
But yeah, dying. You all wake up and we're
oh. Here.
Scam is dying.
Yes, I am dying.
That's right. Tell you not to make an account, suddenly you're dying.
Okay, yeah. Y'all wake up. Y'all are rested, refreshed. You, for a moment, as, you know, Scam and Dave woke up, you do see... Fuck, it's too big. That's what Jakar looks like now when he's summoned in his physical form.
Damn.
Yo, he looks fire! Look at that! Holy moly!
I'm gonna be completely honest, I don't see shit.
No, you connected to that movie. There.
Okay.
Man, I love all these pixels. It's great.
But yeah, Jakar can turn into that as well as the sword still now, because the bonds of whatever is healing him was broken enough by that high-intensity magic juice. Yeah, but you guys all wake up. You're free to do as you will decide what you want to do.
We've been here for, like, many months out of game. I don't remember why we're here anymore.
We were here because we needed to hit this area because we knew this place was important. Story-wise, because it was the original, like,
the OG city.
Yeah.
That got into ruin. I don't know, we were just like, oh, let's just poke around, and then shit happened.
Oh yeah, we sure did poke around.
I think the original path was, like, Mesro, Kirsabal, Nangalore, maybe Heart of Uptal. But I don't think we can make all those before Oralunga descends to madness, so we gotta prioritize now.
Well, Heart of Uptal is probably not happening. For reasons.
Yeah, so Kirsabal. Think there's some stuff going on there. We know Scam's parents and Swallow's family.
I have no family. Just a bunch of idiots.
Swallows, distantly related relatives. They are there. And Nangalore is where Dave has some stuff up according to his weapon skills that the hot lady that I don't remember the name of told you to go to or something. Yeah. Okay. Alright, Feff. Hop, hop.
Let's go.
Okay.
Oh.
You can speak English now, can you?
Oh, yeah, I can. Fuck you.
Are we bringing these two along?
Artist and Dragonbait will turn to you and says, well, I think we talked about, like, trying to get more of the Harpers involved. We can head back to Port Ninzaru and, you know, put out the word.
Alright. We'll appreciate your efforts and guess we'll see you in Oralunga too?
Yeah, I guess if... I don't know what's going down, but it seems like it's big.
Oh, yeah. Shit's happening.
It's okay. And looks at you and your new, you know, demigodish form test. Live long enough, it always feels like shit's happening. They will, you know, jump off the roof. Wave off at you all as they go back towards the north of Mesro and towards Port Ninzaru.
Are they gonna make it in time?
Has Aris ever not made it on time?
Yes.
Name one time.
We were about to die. So.
Did we?
But we didn't. Well, you know what?
That matters is the last one.
Alright, well, as Faf caws and becomes a big-ass bird. Boom. Here. Y'all hop on and make way back for open air. You guys see, as you're traveling, that the ship itself has already made it partially out of the dock area it was, and the frost giants have started sailing out in that dawn of this early day back north around the coast towards the west coast of Chult.
Oh, yeah, we're cool with them now. I forgot about that.
Yeah. As you travel down, is there any specific direction you're going, or going straight to Gears of Ball?
I've had enough of these 4-month-long detours. Let's go.
Okay. You can get just about there over the course of a day. I believe it's 7 tiles. You travel via Fav. Yeah. You fly over the woods, over the jungles, over a large ravine where water trickles out of into the Kitcher's Inlet. Eventually making camp for the night. Is there anything y'all want to do upon making a camp that night?
I was discussing with Chika how to incorporate his newly corporeal form into our battle strategy. Ahahaha.
Oh shit, I should have done that, shouldn't I? Fuck. Okay. Give me a moment. Let me see. Okay, as you make camp for the night, and you were discussing with Jakai in general throughout the ride as well. Jakai's, it's a little unstable at the moment. I think I need some time to focus the energies a bit. I can wing it for now, but eventually I can tell you exactly what I can do. As in, I forgot because of fucking Bangladesh, like, to make a list of all the things he can do. But for now, he will do his own thing on occasion if you run into battle. You still have all your normal abilities.
So what if I, like, can't I trade some of these abilities back?
Trade as in, what do you mean?
Like, aren't I borrowing some part of you right now?
It's... yes, but it's not... like, the form you see before you isn't my full form, right? I am stuck in this Genasi, like, body, where I'm very much not, you know, this is not the height of my power. So, both you as well as this form is pulling from the same reserve. It's not, you know, over Venn diagramming each other.
Oh, okay. So I can't give you anything back.
Well, you could, but it is... it's still sealed. That power would just stay sealed within the gemstone, within the sword.
Okay.
He'll come out in the form of Doctor.
Okay. It would be cool if we could, like, fight while you're corporeal and I'm there. We can, like, kind of gang up on someone, I guess.
Well, we could. You still have all your abilities. Like I said, you're pulling from the same reservoirs as this form is, but... right. I will, you know, test out this body, send some, you know, bolts of fire from the side until I figure out exactly what I can do.
Do you prefer fighting from, like, the back or the front?
I don't know. I'll figure it out. I don't know how much this form can take, but in either case, I would, you know, my soul, it's still trapped in the gemstone, even if his body ceases. It's kind of like, and he walks over to the campfire and points at the bird that is now, you know, in the tree. It's kind of like that one there.
So you mean you're going to be sent constantly off to dangerous missions to get yourself killed?
Are you planning to send me on dangerous missions to get myself killed?
I believe that I'm nicer than Dave is.
Looks at Dave, remembers how he had, like, you know, asked Dave to take the sword at first.
the hell is he looking at?
Well, yes, well, while okay. I figure things out, it'll take probably a day or two, maybe.
Okay, in that case, I'll figure it out later once you figure it out.
That's how this
I'm going to badger the DM works.
Yeah.
I'm going to badger the DM to give me Echo Knight powers.
Anyway, is there anything else you guys want to do in this one night before you reach Kirsabal?
He's just fucking
throw
insane.
Buggers at Swallow.
I burn the boogers that are thrown at me.
I throw more.
David's gonna go take a nap and have full spell slots for the first time in several months.
Well, you did get to sleep, so you have full spell slots.
Oh shit, that's crazy.
That's crazy.
That's crazy.
What else is there? Oh, right. How much more can I pull from the reserves?
I'll be the toot my own horn, but, you know, as handsome as this form is, it's nowhere in strength to my full form.
Alright, so... can I start now?
Oh, that thing we've been doing where you siphon the power into your body?
Yeah, the one where I almost die?
Yes, you could. Yeah. You know, usually I would just, like, let whoever wields a sword go, you know, go for it, but... you sure you want to keep going?
Oh. What's the fine text say?
Well, like I told you, right, last... like I mentioned, you know, at some point, and he, like, you know, mumbles to himself, like, some of my users completely burned themselves out. There was that thing where, you know, siphoning up... you know, you were taking trickles from a dam, but eventually the dam will blow a hole from that weakness. And that's what happened last time.
Oh.
There are complications, to say the least. But, you know, of course, more power is more power. I will not dissuade you from more power.
Okay, I see. You think my puny bird form can't handle it?
And he actually goes, like, contemplative for a sec. Usually I doubt mortals in much of what they do, but you've come a long way, and I understand that it's sometimes alright to warn caution rather than not caring about what happens to those around you.
Wow, that's very thoughtful of you.
I'm very glad. It's fine.
I'm very appreciative that you're willing to think about that. As opposed to letting me die.
Yes, well, don't let it get to your head, your bird brain.
Unfortunate. But...
the offer still stands. It is an open channel that, you know, the further you go, the less sway over it that I will have.
Well, I mean, I'm pretty sure I can just ask people if they can throw all the spells onto me. As long as somebody doesn't invade my mind again, it should be fine, right?
That's true. You seem to have a party that has your back. Strong sense of will to back that up as well. But
right.
Do your best. Just go over here, you know, lean against a tree.
Alright, I go to the rest of the party. Alright guys, I'm going to need to ask some of you to prepare some spells so that I can burn myself up and potentially die.
What the hell?
Alright, the potentially die isn't part of the plans, but...
okay.
I think I'm gonna need some wisdom steroids and some good songs and for somebody to not invade my mind so that she doesn't burn up again.
Please. Like, too busy thinking of different words.
Different words?
Yeah, to name herself after.
Ah.
What are you even doing?
Hmm?
Are you paying attention? Flea?
Yeah! Rates his mind mind so I can catch up on what's going on.
As you make your mind link, you actually hear an accompanying whistle as both you and your other self enters Swall's mind and reads. Basically, who's holding the ring, by the way? That was given by Ulrav?
Scam.
Scam!
Okay, got it.
What?
Nothing, you're good, Scam. Let's see. Yep. Swall is basically thinking of, you know, fire, steroiding himself some more.
And then I realized. I also just opened up my mind because I suspect something's happening. And I will say something like, so this is what you're not supposed to do.
Oh, okay. Bye.
You hear a whistle, and as, you know, she says bye, you see, you know, pink wings going behind you and then leaving your mind.
What do you want from
me? I would like to ask you to prepare some wisdom steroids.
What does that mean?
Would you like to have enhanced abilities so that I don't have to when I burn myself?
Sure would be nice if I fucking had that spell.
You don't? I thought you did.
Nope. Wrong campaign.
Fuck. Guess I'm on my own.
BB has it. Enhanced ability is by you and we have that spell.
Okay, I guess I'm doing it myself. That sucks. That's okay.
I laugh at Swallow.
Wait, if we can do it.
I keep giggling at him.
Well, I mean, she can, but. Yeah, it's fine.
You know, Jakar turns to you. You're bad at talking to people sometimes. Just ask her or tell her to do it.
I don't think it's right to just tell people to do something.
Yeah, it is. They have the choice to say no. You're not making them do it, you're telling them to do it, and then to say yes or no.
Scam, look at your rock.
Hello, rock. I have a rock? I might have thrown it away, I don't know.
Oh my god, please tell me you did not throw the very, very important rock away.
I don't know, which rock was it?
You look in your pockets, you do find a ring that Ulrav gave you.
Son of a bitch.
I'm gonna bring Scam up to the side and, like, give him, start making, like, a necklace for him while they do weird magic shit. It's like, look, they're doing weird mind shit. This isn't our problem.
You're literally glowing!
I am not glowing. I'm glowing.
Hey, could I help? They're doing mind shit and I don't know how to do it.
Do you want to be glowing?
Not really.
Okay, you're not glowing.
Yeah. Fuck you.
You were glowing.
You're on fire literally like 30% of the time.
No, I'm not.
Can I use fabric to make a necklace?
Oh, yeah.
That's crazy.
Dave comes over and puts his hand on the ring you have in your palm, Scam, and you see the metal of the ring itself, you know, unwind and turn into a necklace.
Alright, so here's the plan, okay? Actually, I think you can use that right now. You can use enhanced ability on me to give me wisdom steroids. And I'm gonna bless myself to give myself even more wisdom steroids. And then you can sing a good song.
Wait, can I actually do that though?
Probably.
It's talking for
you. No.
Huh? What? Oh, a song?
Yes, and enhance ability.
Slap him with enhance ability. Does it need touch?
It can if you want it. I don't know.
I slap him with it.
Yeah, this is all very unnecessary. I'm starting to wonder if you're not going to get me over killed the head. Instead.
Bonk him.
What is this all for?
Do you want the song or not?
I'll take the song.
Start playing him a song.
I stand here.
Is this a lit fire pit or no?
I don't think it's lit.
Well, it depends if you want lit. Okay, it's not lit. You just stand in the cold.
It's about to be lit.
Ah, I see. Right. You feel inspired. Right. You feel enhanced.
Okay. I feel like I'm casting Bless on myself.
Next time Swallow gets on fire, I'm gonna prepare a fish to cook against his flaming body.
Well, too bad. You're currently getting a necklace made for you.
Well, next time. Yeah, so there's no issues here. I'm ready, man. I got a fish on a stick. I'm ready.
It's not. It takes 10 minutes.
Oh, you're doing it over the course
of Okay, I bless myself.
Okay, you are blessed as well.
I turn towards the direction of Crystal Ball, which I know very, very well because I am close enough to tell where it is.
Yep. Due south.
Well. With that in mind, I open up the floodgates yet again.
Oh boy, okay. So, current percentages stand at 20% control, that much uncontrolled. You're trying to take that into control, so give me a wisdom saving throw, Swallow.
Ha! This is with advantage, right?
Yes, advantage from enhanced ability. You have a D4 for Bless.
Yay. And a D8 that I'm probably gonna use.
Yes.
Maybe. We'll see. Maybe I can save it if it turns out I need to make two rolls or some shit.
Okay. You feel the channel open, the gate, that dam that had once leaked. Once more, you siphon power.
27.
27. You take control of the stream and you feel it enter your body. You feel a heat that's no longer painful as you've gotten almost accustomed to it reach out further and encompass your body. The feathers that were red start growing and reaching and changing color up your arm some more, getting properly over your chest now. That's 30%, but there's more uncontrolled, and so I will have to ask you for another saving throw.
Okay, I saw that one coming.
Incredible. I rub my palms together, excited to cook my fish.
26.
Okay, that is good enough. With all the buffs and things, your friends aiding you, you feel that fire about to take your mind, searing into your temple, but you control it, you calm it down, and once more the feathers elongate and travel. As everyone watches, Swallow bursts into flames. The campfire itself is aflame now, thanks to him.
A pillar of fire lights up in the sky.
It does.
I go near Swallow. I want to toast my fish.
You think they can see that from Crucible?
I don't think I can respond at the moment.
Oh no, were we trying to be discreet, or you just be like, yo, I'm home?
Yeah, something okay. Like that.
Alright.
I see no point in being discreet. We're walking through the front door.
Alright.
I'm telling you right now, there was an over 50% chance that the scouts were already here. I know how this place works.
As you're talking through the fire, you see now everyone that looks at Swallow, the red feathers have crested themselves and take up a part of his chest all the way down to his tail region, and now his tail is fully red, and it's only the, which side of it that, is it not red yet? Left side, I think. You were holding your sword in the right side, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so your left side remains black, but your right side is almost completely red, including the tail, but your face remains black at the moment.
Okay.
You're at 40%. I'm gonna post this. Where is it? You've gained a wildfire surge.
Is that a good thing?
Yeah. It's a great thing. It's great. Let me post it in campaign log, and I'll post it in room for now and organize later. Okay, there it is for now. If you have questions, let me know. I did write that a while ago, and so we'll update it as need be.
Yeah, let's like not give myself a 49 damage spell again.
Fuck you. Okay, anyway, as you the flame star down to cause like, you know, looks slightly impressed, says, well, that is quite a bit. You've your feathers now, the red ones are almost pressing into you further, whereas like your black feathers are sticking out a little messy from your kinku nature. The red feathers are almost curling themselves into a pattern across your hide, you see now. And Jakal looks on at you and he's like, you certainly kept your control through there. I'm surprised. You had no difficulty at all.
I was feeling motivated. We'll leave it at that. It's going to be a day.
You keep that motivation up. That's, you know, if you can keep that sort of willpower the whole time, then we would not have to worry about, you know, consequences.
Hey, I can't shoot five feathers.
I'll look at that.
But I can use more than three feathers when I'm healing someone, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I'll read the ability again. What is anything the rest of you guys doing?
Well, I made a sick necklace.
She did? As you also, give me an Archon check as you do so, Dave.
Nice.
Okay, very good. Let me just open up some stuff here. Unfortunately, because of a little bit of a jank setup, my notes are not nicely displayed.
Your Bangladesh
like
is
the
loud.
Doctor you are, you've already started your journey of horrible handwriting that nobody can read. Understood.
Okay. So, Dave, as you are fabricating this, you also begin getting a sense of what this stone is capable of. I will send this to you. This is the baseline abilities of the stone, and you get the sense that Ulra asked that she was not chosen as well as she did not make the most use of it. This is very much the level one ability of the stone.
Alright, I walk up to Fui. It's like, well, thanks for your help. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome!
And then I get closer and closer, and then I grapple her and put her in a chokehold and give her a knuckle sandwich.
Okay, give me an athletics check. Fui, if you were trying to resist, you can give me athletics or acrobatics.
Wrong. Yeah. I have to use inspiration.
Wrong. Against you.
Wrong.
Yeah. Swallow fucking just gets you in a fucking neck hold and starts giving you a fucking...
Yeah, I was like, hey, I saw that thing behind you. When are you gonna introduce me, huh?
I'm gonna choke out a quit in command.
Make a wisdom save throw, Swallow.
Wait, that's with advantage. And plus four.
Yeah.
Fuck. I'm never helping you again.
You know that's a lie. Now come on, introduce me.
I haven't thought of her name yet. She's still fucking
name?
She's still sitting here just saying random words out loud.
Wait, why do you need a name?
Why Hello? Do you need a name?
Yeah, but don't you have a name?
I want a new
Wait.
One.
Yo, you have a new
Are
one?
Are you giving me yours?
No.
May I have Look. Your name?
I don't think you want my name, if you really think about it.
Something fairy stole your name.
but what kind of name are you looking for? Also, are you, is that contract still in place?
Don't worry about it. She's
is
fucking
that a yes
saying
or
that
no?
She's just ignoring you.
Oh my god.
Quick question, did he give you your name? Give you his name?
Hmm?
Did he give you his name?
No.
Okay.
No.
Just checking.
Sorry, did I miss something?
Yeah. I started putting Pui in a chokehold.
I was there for that. Did something happen after?
Pui asked if I wanted to give her my name. I said no.
That's cute.
Alright, so what kind of name are you looking for exactly?
Something from my own.
Okay.
Something I can call my own.
What has changed? Besides your friend, I guess.
Isn't that the most important thing that's changed?
I don't really understand for sure.
She's sitting here whistling to herself.
Well, I don't know how to speak your fairy language, but what if you called yourself something along those lines then? Oh, I guess calling yourself a friend is a little cheesy. How about bond? What does bond mean in that language?
This is my name. Get out of here. She kicks you out.
Wait, what's your name?
She kicks you out.
What? I was giving an actual. Alright, fine. Fine. Be like that. Kids these days. I freaking go stomp back to my tent. Is this what they call a rebellious phase?
Alright. People go stomp me off to their tent. Is there anything else those of you out and about still want to do? Scam's eating his fish by the fire.
Delicious.
How long did you cook that?
Don't worry about it.
Kids.
It's fish, man. Come on.
It's scammy.
How come the fish I get is never cooked? Is it because I'm a bird?
I don't know how well you want your fish cooked.
Oh my god.
Maybe you want it raw.
Only if it's cut up and made very pretty and presentable and cold.
Alright, I'll make sure to cut it up next time. Very sloppily. I'll throw it in the air for you. You'll swoop it up like a seagull, alright?
I'm going to sleep.
Okay. Delicious.
This is discrimination.
This fish is so good!
Dave, what you up to?
Hey, Scanner's a necklace. It's yours. Dang.
I chew on the necklace.
Yep.
Yes, this is a necklace.
It's for wearing.
What is it? It's for wearing. Jewels of Chult. Chew alongside a fish.
Yes.
Yes.
It's also for protecting your brain.
Oh. I chew it more.
Yes. No, well,
you don't get that from chewing it!
I don't know, do you?
I don't know.
I finished my fish and throw it.
Do you know that?
Aren't you the wizard? You tell me that.
As you chew it, you do it. And you get the benefits.
Yeah, sure seems to be fucking working, dude.
I hate this. I hate everything.
I throw the fish bones at kids, Swallow.
Kids there these days.
All right, I'm gonna sit on a rock and explain to and slowly explain to Scam what it does.
Yeah. So what does it do? Look, we're sitting around the fire. What does it do?
It protects your brain.
Yeah.
From people looking inside.
So does that mean he can't be read by whoever Fui is now?
If he chooses not to be.
Yeah, it's optional. It's like blocked. You know, you can open it if you want.
Oh.
Yeah. And Scam can also make it invisible while wearing it.
Oh.
I continue chewing on the necklace.
Yeah. Also, if Scam explodes, then Scam will be in the ring, or the necklace, rather.
Isn't that just the thing that I had, except it only worked once?
I don't know, you tell me.
Boy, I got fucking ripped off.
What, you're a fucking divine jewel made into a necklace? I don't fucking think so. Man.
Yeah, bitch. Not my fault. My
God. Hey, Jakob, by the way, were you paying attention when I gave away a minute of my time?
Yeah, I was kind of. It's like, you know when you're dreaming and you kind of see the people in the background?
So how fucked do you think I am?
Well, it depends when that minute is stolen or taken. Or what it's used for.
Well, I suspect it's going to be at a time where I'd really rather not be.
I'm sure it'll be fine, right? What's a minute of time?
I'm
sure you won't come back to see all your friends dead.
I don't know, but my thought was that if it did happen... Well, that's for another time.
Well, if you gave up a minute of your time for nothing, well, that is pretty fucked.
Yeah, I was a little fucked.
That's pretty fucked.
I thought you were thinking of a name.
What?
Yeah, but well, what if? I wonder if I can pass along my stuff to you. When I get a minute taken from me.
That is a thought. I am... Well, at least when I'm in this form, I'm no longer one of your possessions, so... There's a possibility.
Right. There. Exactly. I was trying to figure that part out for a bit, because you were... a sword. But... It's definitely way more feasible when you're like this.
Yes, I don't think it would have worked while I was a sword. I still counted as a possession, an object. But now... I do have some autonomy. I can, and he starts walking off, walk away, and you know, do my own thing, blast some fire out into a tree. Like this stuff, I don't have to wait for a command or be controlled by to do.
Okay. Maybe that's an option when I inevitably get whisked away into who knows what.
It's not a bad idea.
I've definitely had the idea in mind when it happened, it's just... The details weren't quite as clear yet. But even then, I don't know. We'll see. Hopefully it'll just be like... when I'm taking a nap or some shit. But there's no way that's actually gonna happen. Freaking weird-ass ice skating demon things.
Yeah, from what I remember, that is not a kind of being that, as, you know... crazed as they may be, does not have severe intent behind their action.
I also think his point of reference might be somewhat different from mine.
True.
Okay. Alright. Oh, Dave.
Well.
Do you know how to unlock part 2 of that gem, or is that like not going to happen?
Well, I don't know. You want to wait another 10 minutes?
We're literally doing nothing besides being in a tent and or...
Well, I don't know. You want to wait another 10 minutes? Not distracting with words?
Y'all sons. You're all bitches.
Well, I guess I'll work on it for an uninterrupted 10 minutes then.
Alright. As you start putting the thoughts together, Dave, you do... It's not the same sort of, you know, streamlined information you get from other magic items that have been purposely enchanted, right? These have been almost infused via primordial energy into different aspects. Is this the first time you're identifying one of these gems?
Maybe.
Oh, fuck.
It explodes.
Huh. Could you, like...
Mere mortals cannot identify these things.
Do you think you could, like, identify my eye specifically? Does it count as a magical item?
Yes, it's magic, and it's an item.
You must choose one object that you must touch throughout the casting of the spell. Yeah, sure. Yeah, sure, that seems fine and not weird at all.
Alright. What you have before you, Dave, is the Topaz Preservation. It's attuned to the elemental plane of Earth. In addition, it gives that effects which you have, and you get the sense that these effects comes from carrying part of that plane with it. The Earth symbolizing, you know, defense, prioritizing the user's well-being, and, you know, personality staying in one place. There is definite aspects of soul magic here, as you saw. In addition, make an Arcana check.
Okay.
Okay, your mind races, and for a moment you can see, like, flashes of history. This gem has been around a long time, since it was very much gifted by Umdao to the Bare that held it and used it as a siphon for power for that the Earth elemental plane for the Topaz.
So, what's the consensus? I got a phone call from downstairs.
It's still going. You get the sense that this gemstone, right? The more it becomes imbued or attuned to a user, it grows in strength depending on that user. So that what abilities right there is the baseline of what it can do. But as it grows more accustomed to the user, as the user ventures down and takes on different paths and different choices, it grows with that individual.
Alright, Scam, I hope you can handle that responsibility.
What responsibility? Wait, I have a responsibility now?
You're wearing the soul of the plane of the Earth. Oh. It's also a neat necklace, and I made it myself.
Yeah,
you're
I
like
really
the
necklace.
You're really proud of that, aren't you?
Yes. I chew on the necklace more.
How pretty is this necklace?
Mm?
It's beautiful. Did Dave minor in art?
It's beautiful.
Okay.
There it is! I say while chewing the necklace.
You chew upon the soul of the plane of the Earth.
Yes.
As he
there are no consequences.
To chew on it, and you think, Dave, you do get the sense that many of the gemstones probably work in a similar manner. And, you know, they, you know, develop with the user.
Is that going to cause teeth damage?
Yes, enamel erosion.
There are no issues here, I think. my tooth chips off a little bit. Continue chewing on anyways.
Yeah, that's what you know.
Neat. That's what we know.
Delicious.
Dave lectures the class on all that he learned.
All
right. Is your gem like still like a physical thing that you're wearing on like your hand or something, or is it like consumed by your soul? I look down at it.
It is still embedded in the back of your hand.
Oh, okay. Do you want to look at this one? Psst. Dave. Slap him.
That's...
Bonk.
Yeah, I'm gonna guess identify all the fucking things.
On all the rocks. Hey, Jakar, how does it feel to get identified?
No, that's still not happening. I'll tell you what you need to know.
Alright, that one passes.
You don't need me to grab Jakar for 10 minutes?
I'm uncomfortable with that proposition.
Don't worry, me too.
Look, turns to swallow. As you crawl, the last person you had identifying me was a little forceful.
Oh, yeah, we still have to deal with that. I'm sure she'll be ecstatic to know that you're like this now.
Oh, boy. Dave, as you identify all of them, you do see that of the gemstones you have, Fui's Emerald, Tess's Amethyst, Swallow's Ruby, and Scam's Topaz are all attuned to a different plane of existence. Swallow's is understandably the elemental plane of fire. Tess is the elemental plane of air. Fui is the Feywild. And then you have the elemental plane of earth and the Topaz. They each have different symbologies, different uses, different concepts behind them. The Amethyst of Truth that Tess carries, the Ruby of the Chained that Swallow carries, the Blossoming Emerald that Fui carries, and the Topaz of Preservation that Scam carries. As you are recalling this information and you have a keen mind, you recall that Karui's body also has a onyx. As you recall the names that you were told, likely the soulbound onyx that likely has an attunement to the Shadowfell.
Neat.
Each of them are attuned and use those elemental energies, and they each have an aspect of soul magic with them. Whereas the Topaz can house a soul very much like Karui's could, right? The Ruby of the Chained already houses a soul, and Chained Ifrit, which Jakar goes into detail of how like his soul is bonded to the gemstone. The Amethyst of Truth, as Tess has, you know, bodied into herself, allows her to see other things through very much a soul gaze. Whereas Fui's, you know, alters her own very soul and causes it to grow and blossom with strengths anew.
Neat.
Continues chewing on necklace.
Yeah.
Ow, my eye, it's so dry.
Oh.
You okay?
I've been rubbing it for 10 minutes, so yes. You'll be okay.
Everything's fine. You want to chew my necklace? It'll help.
You know, I would say that's not good for you, but seeing how apparently doing that gives you powers, I'm not really in a position to say anything anymore, am I?
Kind of wish I had yours, so then I could cook fish anytime.
Did you compare me to a campfire?
No. Of course not.
I nod. He did, yeah.
To, you know, douse you in flames.
Wait, I could use myself to cook fish? Hell yeah.
That's not what I said. That is the opposite of...
Yeah.
No. Jakar, just leave it be.
Yes.
How does it feel having to interact with people now?
I remember why I was not a fan of mortals.
What about that one?
What's that one?
The bird.
Switch it now. I think I already knew that though.
Delicious. Alright.
So I would say we should all go to sleep, but seeing that we're like maybe 2 stones away from Crystal Ball, I guess we should stay awake in case we don't want our stuff stolen, but like
I should just set up watch.
Yeah.
Do I need to sleep? I think I still need to sleep, right?
You still very much want to sleep.
Okay.
I think my kinsmen.
Yeah.
I think my kinsmen probably already know we're here by this point, and some of them might have some sticky fingers. Or sticky feathers, I guess. We have hands.
Okay, I mean, set up watch then.
Alright. The new way we do watch, we just do two blocks of watches, right? So multiple people can do each block. Who's doing the first watch?
Pick me.
Hey, Dave, anyone else?
I can help.
Okay, Dave and Fleet. Let's fucking get it. Everyone else gets comfy and however they want to get comfy. Is the fire on or off?
Is it cold?
Yeah.
It's on.
Yes.
Okay. It's on.
Everyone gets to bed. Jaka, you know, after people go to bed, just wanders off over here. And then the two of you go on watch. Give me perception checks.
I squint the entire time.
Okay.
you didn't squint good enough. I think you rubbed your eye for too long.
Where is perception? What
the fuck? Skill check. Skill check. Damage, healing, resting, skill check. Oh, you mean in that menu?
Something.
Hey! Alright!
Christmas!
What are you guys talking about, by the way, while you're definitely distracted?
Names.
It all sounds the same to you.
Nummies?
I'm just whistling sounds at you, and you're like, that sounds the same, you know?
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Dave's opinion, but not the birds. I see how it is.
You know the eyeglasses test is like number one or number two?
Oh, yo.
Number one or number two?
Four.
That was a good choice.
Three,
I like that one.
Four. They both look the same. All right. Five or six?
You keep just hear her give off names over and over, Dave, and you're just like, that one. Oh, no, that one's also good. It just goes on.
No, that's a good choice. That was a good choice. I like that one.
Wait, what language? Are these all in Sylvan for you?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, Dave, you don't understand this shit.
Do I? I don't know.
I don't believe you do. I checked last time, and Fui's actually the only one that knows Sylvan.
Makes sense.
Yeah, it goes back and forth for multiple hours. Eventually, time passes, the moon is high in the sky. Who's next on watch?
Me.
Swallow wakes up. You wake up and see these two are definitely fucking distracted.
First thing I do a perimeter to see if anything was stolen.
Investigation check.
I'm also guidancing myself. It doesn't matter.
Is he the only one that wakes up?
Whoever would have you guys decided. Tess, did you want to wake up for the second watch?
Yeah.
Alright, Tess walks up too.
You see, hey, help me out here.
Swallow is like fucking, you know, butt first in this tent, just searching it, and it's a little stuck. Alright, you take a look around and you don't see anything misplaced or stolen. You do see a couple of tracks. It seems like someone that walked over that way that you're going to assume to be Jakar. For the most part, everything seems fine during that first watch, even though these two are not aware of their surroundings.
I'm gonna ask Faf if he was paying attention.
Faf is sleeping in the tree.
Fuck.
He's a fucking owl!
He fucking flew all day for your bitch ass.
Alright. Sometimes it'd be like that for sure.
You're gonna make Faf take a 22-hour shift.
No, we have very ethical working conditions in the familiar. Wizard familiar accord of 11 minutes ago.
No, I feel like I have better working conditions than whatever this wizard freaking accord is.
Well, Fui and Dave, you're finally allowed to go to rest and sleep it off. Dave, you can go meditate for 4 hours.
Yep.
Tess and Swallow, give me perception checks as you keep watch for the second half of the night.
Did I get perception advantage?
Nope.
What did I get for the... I can never remember what I got from the thingamabob.
Expertise is soul coin.
Alright, but didn't I get something else for that?
No, navigation tools.
Was it just that?
It was a tools and a skill check. Proficiency. Okay.
I'm trying to remember what the proficiency was. Also, where can I find this? Because I never remember.
It's in your party notes, as well as it should be updated on your token ready.
Party notes. Man, where do I find that?
It's in campaign log.
Got it. Party... Okay, sure. I'm gonna assume everything's fine. Skill check. Perception. I guidance myself.
Okay, so even higher than that, because there's no plus three either. So you both actually pay attention. What are you guys talking about during the night as you're just, you know, spending the 4 hours listening out?
So, are you gonna, like, pick us up if we go down in the future?
I have faith you will all be able to handle it.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. I'll just pay more attention to when people go down. But you do your thing. So, like, do you still get angry?
I'm meditating.
I was just sitting here like, does Ascending do anything? I can't really tell if anything changed.
Tess has no answers for you. You must seek them out yourself.
Oh, I see. You're just throwing out Zen cones at this point. Understood. Is that what it means to become a master?
The gods will not... Shit.
I think the god is already tired of my shit.
Hello?
Yep.
Hello.
Oh, I thought it was broken for a minute. Oh, I guess it was just the music that broke. Or stopped.
It stopped.
Yeah. Okay. Anyways, I'm just fucking around being like, the gods will not give you the answers you want. You must seek them out yourself.
Destruction.
Thanks.
I'm just being deliberately not helpful.
Mm-hmm. I'm just coming to the conclusion that nothing really has changed.
Well, as you are, you know, in the middle of another koan, right? Both of you hear a blood-curdling shriek deep to the south.
Is this a long enough rest?
You receive the short rest, both of you.
I apparently still have clairvoyance prepared.
Yeah.
Can I attempt to check out what it is to clairvoyance, or sure. Do I need to actually know where it is?
No, that actually works. This is a perfect use of clairvoyance. What does it look like when you cast clairvoyance?
You see, kind of like a small wisp of flame appear in my like on top of my arm, and it shoots up into the sky and flies off.
As you watch, as Swallow concentrates, as you both look up towards the sound, the wisp of flame rises into the air and goes streaking in that direction. It goes through woods, you know, dark trees against the blackness before.
Also, it's supposed to be invisible, but.
Yeah, well, it becomes invisible. You see it, bitch.
Okay.
You see what appears to be movement as you further and further go down, and through the woods you see a shape dart shrieking into the night. It looks massive, but not large. It's bulky, and it's standing on these like spindly legs of sorts, spindly four legs and appendages. It's, you see pink, you see black, you see flesh poking out, as well as black feathers, and you hear another shriek.
Okay, what am I seeing? Besides pink and black and feathers.
That's what you're fucking seeing, bitch. It's fucking dark.
It's dark?
Yeah.
Shit.
You're seeing movement as your clairvoyance is racing through the woods.
Start waking the others up.
Oh shit. Who needs murdering?
Something black and pink and with black feathers, but I suspect the black feathers is people like me getting.
Are we murdering the feathers or the pink?
This is all the same entity.
Oh.
You see like flesh peeking out of places, as well as feathers and others.
Yeah, it kind of sounds black. Like they squished up a bunch of bird bodies together into a.
Yeah, this is not what I wanted to think about, but I hate the fact that you're right.
Anyways.
Hey, Jakar, are you here?
Mm-hmm.
Hello?
Yes, I can see what you're seeing. You hear the voice in your head.
Do you have a better vantage point where you are?
My physical body was just out near the camp. It wasn't far. I'm using the clairvoyance as you are.
Oh, okay. Got it. Alright, are we heading that direction? Yes, no?
I can make the clairvoyance. I think I can. I have a bit more access to my powers. I can make the wisp of flame light up. We can see a closer image of the creature, but it'll make the wisp, you know, visible.
I think that's fine.
Alright. You see light go around the edges and light the forest around you, and you get the following image. Where is it? As for a moment you are face to face with this creature as it roars in the direction of the light. You see. Here, I'll just post out this image so greened out the full token. You see that.
Wow! I don't remember my kinsmen looking like this. Yeah, I think they have a little too many eyes.
It's a friend.
What are these things we're stalking through the woods?
Is that your friend, Swallow?
No.
Well, you guys don't see this. Swallow sees this with clairvoyance, like, hundreds of feet away.
I see this.
Oh, yeah, you fucking mind link.
Yeah, this is... So, I wouldn't say I really have friends in the village, but even if I did, none of them look like this.
As the wisp lights up, you see the creature, like, turns towards it, like, caws out, and almost the sound and air between it and the wisp reverberates with energy, and the wisp dissipates.
Yeah! I'm kind of curious, what happened? Nobody I've ever met looked like that. Something curious must have been happening at home, I guess.
Something curious is happening.
Ah! Man, were the snake people, like, genetically engineering other of my kind? What the fuck?
Oh, did we see snake people, or are we just assuming, like...
I'm just making assumptions.
Well, I think that one, Arakoka, who was it, that we met, said the UNT was approaching Kirzabal.
Oh, right. But I don't remember. Like, I know for sure that when I was in Crucible, nobody had the know-how to even attempt to do this, much less actually do it.
Did you see? I mean, did you see any other, like, of your people or Arakoka in Crucible? Like, were there any, like, Anybody running? I mean, who was it? This thing that was screaming, or was there someone else?
It's this thing. I didn't see anyone else. Now, we could attempt to leave it alone, I guess, but I mean, think it might be too late for that.
I mean, were you expecting to see someone else, or was it like in just like an area? Like,
well, I was hoping that, you know, some scouts will come by, and then they try to spy on us or steal something. We knock them out, get information out of them, but not this, no.
Aren't you worried about your tone?
Let me put it this way. If it's out here, that means it's probably not in there. Probably.
Well, I mean, so the area you were looking at, you're not expecting it to be populated. Like, it wasn't, like, abandoned. So there's probably still people at Kirzabal, right?
Yeah, I think there's still people there. It was not... I'm pretty sure we didn't make it that far down that we reached the city. We're still in the outskirts.
Yeah, from what you remember, Kirzabal is a ancient monastery that the Aarakocras took over that's still, like, a couple miles south.
I did not look that far down.
The Kengus lived, you know, away from Kirzabal at the base of the mountain, like in a small village.
Yeah. Now, there might be some concerns that one is out here because Kirzabal is being overrun by these things, but there's no way for me to really know that for sure. Oh, in any case, what's the plan? Are we beating it up? Yes, no? Honestly, if it's someone of my kind turned into that, it's probably best to put him out of its misery at this point. Unless you can change back, I guess. Then.
I mean, we're already all awake. What are we going to do? Go back to sleep?
I don't know if I want to go back to sleep with that thing running around.
I wonder if I can change it back.
Hmm. You can try. I don't know how it works. I'm sure Dave can figure something out if he looks at it.
Alright, I guess we pack up and go to the south.
Alright, let's go.
Alright, so in the middle of the night, you guys are wandering to the south?
Are we going to get a long rest?
No. If you're going now.
Let me check out my spell slots.
It's basically 4 more hours till sunrise, at which point you will get your long rest. Even Dave has...
We had one after... We had one after the Witchmahala, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So you're just missing spell slots for things like enhance ability, clairvoyance. Fabricate.
I use some spell slots. I also forgot to change.
Did I do my toying cost before or after the long rest?
You did it after.
Okay. So, yeah, so I don't get one of those features, but it's fine.
Alright, I think I'm okay with missing one inspiration and one spell slot.
Before all this, do you get inspiration from the review this
earlier? So. That was a good recap.
And does Dave get inspiration for calling engine?
Oh yes, he does.
All right. Contributing. He said yes.
He's gonna take it away from just being late.
Engine's gonna now be late every time to farm it.
I will fucking kill you guys so fast.
Rocks fall from the sky.
But yes, you guys are free to do as you will. If you wish to travel now versus in the morning, it's up to you.
I guess I could try to see if it's likely. I think we should go now. Maybe if we clean it up fast enough, we can go back to sleep earlier.
It is... The clairvoyance, what's the range of clairvoyance? Pretty far, right?
I remember. Something like that, let me check. It's not that far.
Further.
I don't think it's actually that far. Clairvoyance. Range. 1 mile.
Yeah, so it was like a mile away.
Wow.
It was like, you know, sure. The streak that you see, and you see birds in the distance, like, fly out of the trees. Like that cool. Distance.
Birds upon birds upon birds. Welcome to the country of birds. Sure. I think it was that way.
Okay. Are you guys walking off really? In the distance, or flying, or what are you doing?
Well, Faf could...
No, Faf can't actually fly until he gets the full rest.
Yeah, but can he fly in small form?
Yeah, you can fly in small form, but he can't carry you, is what I mean.
Yeah, we can still go out and get a better pinpoint on it. I don't think it can fly, the big creature. I think. Actually, Faf, maybe you should stay up a little higher just to be safe.
It's not yet dawn, right?
It is not.
Yeah, but
I can make us all fly. I can make us all fly. Yeah, and then we could, I don't know, do another wait until dawn shit, or I could just go in with missing charges.
I think if... Actually, the first thing we should do is probably ask Faf to take a look around. Right? Just... Dave, what do you think?
He can peek. I'm sure you just need to point the right way.
Last time
that way.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
So you want me to peek down there, fly there. How far can you see the room again?
Let me check.
I think it's really far.
Faf can see what Faf can see, but my mind length is not unlimited.
It's not a mile.
It is 100 feet only.
Okay, never mind.
So he can go and report back, but it'll be him reporting back, and you know, hopefully, nothing helps him.
Just like get eaten.
Yeah.
Okay, maybe not. Maybe let's get closer before we do that.
We'll point the way.
Still fly.
We can, if you want us to fly, sure. I mean, Jakad can fly, probably. I would have to summon a sword to fly, but I could do it.
Well, I'm saying.
Okay, never mind.
I mean, how is it like running amok really far, or is it like, why don't we just head towards it?
Looks like it was having a grand old time yelling at the trees or some shit.
Yeah, just walk, man.
Alright.
Alright, y'all walking down. Consensus?
Sure.
Brisk walk.
Brisk walk. So
I keep an eye out for traps.
I mean, I could... how many people need stealth, or are we just, like, charging in?
I mean, we probably will find its tracks before we find it, so probably be fine.
If we take too long, it's just gonna get farther away from us.
I can do pass without trace, but I could, but like, that'll spend some key.
Unless
or I can make us all fly and we can just go.
No, it's like, once we catch some wind that something's around, we'll be more careful. But for now, we'll just go.
I guess we're not particularly trying to stealth, but we are focusing on speed then.
I'm looking for tracks, but that's about it.
Okay. So, stealth or no stealth? Final call.
No stealth.
Okay. Give me, if you're looking for tracks, a survival check. Do you have light up, or are you doing this blind? Like, in the dark?
Yeah, I have light up.
Okay.
My sword is alight and burning, and we shall see.
Alright, survival check. Okay. So, Swallow, you're looking at tracks and you get a string of nausea because things start to look familiar. Things are very familiar. You and your band of Kenku have traveled this ground multiple times on the way to Port Ninzaru. The path.
I'm too busy.
You see these trees, you see the rocks, and you just get a wave of nausea of, like, bad memories.
Some good ones too, but A lot of bad ones, yeah.
A lot of bad ones. Fui, seeing this, step up, and you do spy Fui. After about, like, 10 minutes of travel, you see a tree that has, like, splinters on it, and in the splinter you see a patch of black tuft.
I call out in Mind Link. You know, we're not being full stealth, but no need to shout out exactly where we are. Hey guys, look at that! I point out the tree to them.
Huh? What?
That tree? What is that?
Huh. I wrap the feathers and look at it, I guess.
You see a tuft of matted, black, oily feathers and fur that's almost matted. Like, it's feathers, but matted into almost like a fur-like density. It's caught into the tree, and you see another pile further down, as we pointed out, that is definitely leading further south. And you definitely, you know, get the sense it is leading to a very familiar village, Zwala.
Oh, yeah. That's...
Even though Kirsibal's a little bit further, you know, on the way, you do know it's located in the charnel fields where the king could make their home.
Why is it heading in that direction of all places, anyways?
Do you think your village is okay?
I don't know.
You should probably hurry up and check.
Might be too late. We'll find out, I guess. Let's get this thing first. We'll figure out the details later.
Alright. You all continue walking down, following the trail, following as well as sense of direction. How... Like, you're not stealthing, but are you walking? Are you running? How are you going?
I don't think we need to run. It might still be far away.
Okay. You continue down through the woods, the darkness, and eventually, you know, hours begin to pass. It is still quite a ways, and you forgot how it feels to walk through the jungle after being able to fly for so long. It's arduous travel. You travel for an hour, 2 hours, and eventually can see that the sky is getting lighter.
Wait. It takes that long to travel a mile?
Nope, you traveled a mile and you didn't find anything. Like, you found that tuft of hair.
But isn't it 2 miles away, Kirsibal?
No, Kirsibal is 2 hexes away, which is 20 miles.
Okay, I see.
Right. But you remember, you know, half that distance is where the village would lie.
Okay, I see.
And so, after about a couple of hours of travel, you do approach, you know, as the light is up, you swell in your memories, remember the village just behind a set of hills.
Huh. Have we been keeping track of their tracks this whole time? Is it still heading that direction?
Yeah, like every so often, maybe every 10, 15 minutes or so, you've seen some sign of a creature passing through here, a tuft of fur there, scratch marks here.
This doesn't make any sense. Where are the scouts? If it was heading this direction, there should be some sort of indication that something awful is happening right now. The scouts should have sent back word.
As you see, you don't see any real sign of struggle or hunting or blood or anything. It seems these scratches and things were almost just left behind by a creature traveling through the night and not, like... It doesn't at least see any combat signs out this far yet.
So I would say, like, based on my knowledge of Kirsibal, around this point is kind of like where the patrols would start happening. Right?
Yep.
So the fact that nothing happened yet, normally it's like not that easy to just walk into the forest and not get noticed at this point.
Yeah, there's usually a kinku here or there in the trees, like looking out for people.
Right. So if nothing happened, either they went back to report, or they know what it is and they're okay with it.
Or there's no one to report.
Or yeah. There's no one to report because there's also no one watching.
I pat Swallow reassuringly.
Well, I mean, it could be any number of things. I guess you just buck up and get ready, I guess.
As dawn's light approaches, at your backs, you guys do see the village open up ahead. You guys can be as far away from this as you want, because Wall does know where it is.
Are we within 100 feet yet?
Give me a sec. I forgot.
I see a full black map, but... Oh, there it is.
Yeah, I think it's time to ask Faf to you take a look around first. We don't need to commit anything yet.
Faf, go squint.
Okay. Yes, sir. And he goes in. Flies, does an aerial view of the whole place. Give me a perception check for Faf.
If I mind link Dave, do I mind link Faf?
Yeah.
Oh, it's transitive?
Yeah.
might have advantage. I don't remember.
He does. Yes, he does.
Yeah, he has advantage when he's looking at stuff.
Bird eyes. Okay, that's pretty good. Faf does a bird's eye view, goes over the whole place, and at first this place does seem abandoned. There's no signs of life. You do see structures smaller than average that might house kinkus and whatnot. You see barrels and things, but they don't seem like they've been used in a while. The recent rain has left some pools of water, as well as the river around it soaked. But no signs of life. You do see what appears, though. You catch sight of a perception check. There are scratch marks in different places around the village, in the soil itself, in the dirt. Large scratch marks that you have seen on your way here.
Neat, seems safe.
You can control Faf if there's anywhere you want to look in particular.
Check
sure
the
anything in particular to look at. Sure.
Check the elders' lodgings.
Which one's that?
The big one.
Alright, look at the big one. Check it out, Faf.
Okay. Faf goes in. Faf has dark vision.
Yeah. 120 feet dark vision.
Okay,
so.
Cool. So, let me just fuck with this one. There we go. As Faf gets in there, you see immediately, right? It's even darker in here than it should be, right? Like, there should be some light filtering through, but there isn't. Almost as if this miasmic, you know, darkness is residing there. It takes him, like, he needs to actually enter it to see inside, and as he does, you get near, you hear scratching inside. You hear the sound of something chewing, something eating. And give me a stealth check for Faf.
Okay.
Alright. The moment Faf enters darkness, you hear this chewing, you see what appears to be the matted corpse of a deer or some other large animal on the ground, open up blood, and over its form you see something black and feathery that immediately it becomes a flash of black that turns towards Faf and... You lose contact with that vision.
Wow. I think that one's my fault.
He'll be okay.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's according to the Accord, he gets time off now.
How long does that last?
That's private between the employer and the familiar.
You're about to summon him in 5 minutes, aren't you?
Fuck off, it takes longer than that. Alright, it's all good.
Like Fui's just frowning. She doesn't like what she's seeing.
There's a spooky beast in there.
How large was it?
This large.
I assume Faf has been sacrificed once again.
He may or
no,
may
he's
not
on vacation.
He may or may not have been. Yeah. It may be unfortunate. Yet again.
You hear a whistle in your thoughts, Flea. as, you know, the entity within you is a lot more able to communicate with you now than before, and it whistles a sense of discomfort and a sense of... Whereas you can sense life energies, this seems like the opposite. There's a strong sense of death, necromantic energies from the village.
Is it similar to, like, Nanny Poo Poo side in my soul?
Well, kind of. Less controlled.
Okay.
It whistles in your head and you feel its discomfort before it, you know, goes back in the back of your mind.
Well, we'd have to help them. It is... It swallows people, you know?
I mean...
Oh, there's them to help.
Yeah. At this
Maybe
point, we might...
fix it. You know?
Well,
if we, like, raises her hands with the gem in the back of it.
Let's look around first. This should be the reception area where we quote-unquote welcome visitors, which doesn't usually happen, but... We do need to put it up in case the Aarakocra ever decide to visit for some god knows what reason. Just something about showing respect and all that.
Should we... I mean... We've been traveling for a while. Do we want to try to get the rest rest up before we... approach further? Or... are we too close to back out now?
I mean...
We need to get a rest.
If there's nobody here, it's probably time to take a rest. But I can't ascertain that, so let me check this reception area first. Maybe there's someone there. Probably not, but who knows. At the very least, there should be records.
I can keep watch while you guys...
Right, I'm going to... sneak my way over.
Okay, give me a stealth check.
Oh, if we're gonna rest and you're gonna stealth, I'm gonna give you pass out, Trayson.
Sure. I also got it to myself. Might as well.
Alright, so 31 total. Go ahead and move your token. As you approach this tent, you remember, you know, Kenku's ever stand on guard that, you know, had to watch out for the hunting parties that came back, for the scavengers, you know, made sure everyone was accounted for, reported back, and you see an empty hut. It seems like most of the possessions are not here, as if they were taken and moved. You look around, and it doesn't seem like there was any signs of struggle. It seems very much abandoned, like whoever was here just picked up their things and left.
So it's just an empty hut.
Yep.
I rummaged around to see if there was any sort of records left.
Okay. You rummage around. Give me an investigation check.
With guidance.
Mm-hmm.
Might as well.
As you rummage around, you find bits of paper that, like, bits of, you know, the rough paper and things you can, because you made out of bark, right? Purchasing that shit's not happening. So you guys used what you could to make small hand notes, right? Scratches here and there to identify, you know, what things you guys brought back, what the hunting parties brought back, what your thieving runs brought back.
Okay,
but
so...
you see the last one is dated quite a ways ago. And it was dated instead of being stuff brought back, stuff given by a party of strangers, and the symbol that's used to differentiate them is a snake.
There should also be records of outgoing things, like parties or whatever.
Mm-hmm. There seems to be parties of, like, parties of Kenku leaving, right? But it's not like the ones that left, they didn't come back with things necessarily. They seem to be sending out on missions and little notes. Each of those notes at that point have like snake symbols around them. Eventually you see like hunting parties and things going out, but they dwindle and gets less and less frequent until most of the parties are going out with this snake symbol attached to them. And you get the sense it's like, you know, you know, hired missions or jobs and parties like you ran into last time.
All right, I'm leaving the hut sneakily.
It's okay, we'll keep the first stealth check.
Good. I leave.
Alright, can you join the party?
So, if there's no traces of people, after we rest, do we want to try to handle this directly? There's also Kirsa Ball, maybe if there's still people there, we could ask them about this creature and see if they know anything about it.
I suspect my people migrated.
To Kirsa Ball or just away from here?
To the Snakelands.
Right?
Last time we saw a party of them, remember?
So now, they're working with the UNT?
Yeah, I think that's what's happening. I think they are very solidly in cahoots at this point. And their migration is also, in fact, probably complete a while ago now. Probably, what were you even doing back then? But I'm guessing by the time we encountered them on that bridge, it was already set in stone. The decision was made a long time ago.
Well, from the dates, you see that that was likely one of the missions, and so it was most likely maybe a month, a couple of weeks around that range ago, that, like, they stopped making notes.
I'm afraid we're too late. Whatever the Kenkus are, they're in the hands of the snake people now, and between you and me, if the snake people wanted us dead, we'd be dead. So, if they're alive, that means they must have been deemed useful.
What about fucking that? Excuse,
that? Good question. Maybe it's someone from here that's mutated. Maybe it's some sort of experiment. I don't know. I do know that most people here do not exist. They have moved out.
However, a concha.
Sure.
As he's talking about these experiments and whatnot, you do remember that there's a certain individual who you're preparing to deal with that has a tendency to experiment with the undead.
Who are you friends
with?
Your girlfriend.
Well, no, not the what? The fucking Acerac.
Oh, what the?
He sent an undead werewolf after you. He sent an undead plant thing after you. He basically.
I thought we had actually met, right? Like, yeah, physically.
Physically.
Alright. Well, yeah, there's some fucking weird shit. Yo, this is some fucking... This smells like lich bullshit afoot.
Well. In any case, the fact that it's... Something is eating inside the village suggests to me that they have the capacity to think still. After all, why would a creature, or at least recognize that these homes exist, potentially? So we probably should be on our guard, but probably fine to just hang out and finish resting before we go in and do anything.
So, do you have sending prepared?
I have never learned that spell.
Is it? Oh, it's not just on your
list. I don't learn spells, to be fair.
Yeah.
Let me check.
Have you ever considered phoning home? Like, you know, you ever considered just like asking about where they went?
No. I was exiled, remember?
I feel like the circumstances have changed given that the place that you've been exiled from is no longer populated.
It's more about the spirit of the thing, but there's no one. Everyone that I would be willing to come in contact with is dead. I fled, essentially. You could say it was a disgrace, but I got tired of this shit. People, birds being sacrificed for stupid reasons. So
I would like to point out that we came back here. Like,
yeah,
we are here.
I know.
So, I mean, like, if you were willing to physically come here, then you should probably be also willing to use the phone. Since you were coming here to talk to them in person, you know.
Let's see. Yeah, I was hoping to, like, just ask around, like, random people, but can't really do that with Sunday, can I?
Do you know literally anyone who is likely to be alive?
Yeah, the Elder, who is very unlikely to give us information that we're looking for.
Hey, are you alive?
You would have probably known other people as well. If you, like, it's up to you to even think of an NPC you would know from the village.
There's some, like, younger siblings of people that I knew who died. They might still be in it. Although I suspect my attempt on their lives may make them more reticent. Well, their other people's lives might make them more reticent to talking. Which one of these might be most reliable? Also, I'm going to be completely honest. It's very likely that once I come into contact with them, they're going to tell the elders.
Is that bad?
Well, I guess they would know we're onto them. I mean, do you guys care about that? It'd be one thing if, you know, we were in their face in person, but we're probably on the wrong side of the continent right now. Just gives them more time to prepare or whatever. Actually, if there was a way, if I could scry, theoretically, I could just check up on them, but I'm not strong enough for that at the moment. Actually, where does a Yuan-Ti live? Check the map, right?
So, you were told that the Wanti, as well as Asirik himself, are based in Obu. And this is where, likely, you know, things go down. This is the capital of Big Bad.
Well,
this is where
there
the death
is someone.
Is coming from.
There is someone we can contact that will probably give us a relatively straight answer and doesn't care enough to actually say, like, to bother a subterfuge response, who is in the area.
Okay.
I can phone Lord Asirak.
You can do that, like, 40 miles away from me.
Yeah, you don't want to be around while I, like, issue very non-threatening death threats. No? Not a thing you're into?
No, I'm good.
Okay. Yeah, I guess I could also ask Lord Asirak if he left any goodies in the village.
No, I'm good.
Yeah?
I changed my mind. Forgot the setting spell.
Yeah.
Forget cool. It. Never mind. We're good. Just tell me if I'm supposed to throw a fireball at that house or not.
It's probably going to happen. I'm going to join you.
Alright. Then I guess we're camping out for the night. Or
the
day at this time. Morning.
Rest of the morning.
Yeah.
Anyone who wants to keep watch of weird bird people, you can go do that.
You guys are backing away from the village a bit, finding a place to camp down for the rest of your rest.
Yeah.
Okay. Y'all back out and can finish your rest. Are you doing watches once more?
I am. I already did my watch, I think. Alright.
Well, you guys were interrupted in your tests.
I mean, I guess I can finish the rest of the first watch.
Right. I mean, I'll be finishing the watch, but by that, I mean, I'm opening up my spell book.
Okay. Go ahead, give me perception checks, whoever is keeping a watch for these couple of hours, just so you guys can feel completely refreshed.
I didn't make my bubble as well. It's been a while since I've said that.
Oh, yeah, we forgot about the bubble.
The bubble.
It's time for the bubble.
Oh, I should wake Faf up too. Yeah, the fuck up.
That wasn't a very long break.
He'll be okay.
Do I really have a plus 11 to my perception check?
Yeah, that's the soul coin.
Nice. I saw.
You see. Faf returns as the bubble also goes up and Tess and Twala keeps watch. Faf is just like, get off. I'm getting sick and tired of dying for your dumb ass.
Yeah, no, that one was my fault. To be fair. I'm sorry about that. I didn't realize that was going to happen.
Staff a hug. I didn't like that either.
Can you describe what you saw? Because I mean, we were watching, but also like...
Well, yeah. you've got mind power thingy majiggies, right? You can connect to Faf.
Well, actually, I probably should just look inside the house. I could do that before the
or
rest
that,
is over.
Or that,
right? Yeah.
I could do that before the rest is over. Okay. Mm-hmm. I clairvoyance in the house during my watch, I guess.
Okay, you clairvoyance into the house. Let me check clairvoyance real quick. Yeah, it doesn't give you dark vision or anything, right?
I don't believe so.
So it is matted blackness. But you can at least, I'll give you a sense of hearing as well. You do hear eating sounds, gnawing sounds.
Can I move that voice around?
Give me a perception check as well. Huh? Repeat that?
Oh. Can I move it around? I need to track the spell.
I will say yes. Okay. As part of, you know, your studies into clairvoyance, you gain that if it doesn't come with the spell normally.
I check in the house every once in a while to see if it's still there, but I also take a peek into all the other houses.
After a while, its feeding ends, right? And it moves around, but doesn't seem keen to leave for whatever reason.
Okay.
You check all the other places. Let's see. Yeah. You hear sounds coming from quite a few of the other ones. And from...
Sounds.
Yep, sounds, because they are all also encompassed by blackness that you cannot see through, that doesn't let light filter in. I will point them out on the map now. So, you hear sounds, if you check a bunch of these tents, right? These scratching and gnawing sounds of some life form. Here? 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 And multiple here.
Yeah, sorry, my bad, it was me.
So
all the big
circle
ones and the big one?
Yeah.
Yeah. So each of the medium circles, I think, has one, and apparently the big one has multiple.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. With that unsettling news, I guess I'll finish my rest.
Alright, y'all finish
and
your rest.
And I will go, I'm gonna go prepare for destroying things.
Alright, y'all finish your rest without issue, keep an eye out. It does not seem anything is looking to, you know, come out of that village, at least at this time. You guys start getting the sense that whatever this thing is, it's likely does not like sunlight very much and wants that darkness.
I'm pretty sure the huts are made of wood.
Are they?
Wait, you said these things like the darkness?
Yes. It seems like it's not a fan of coming out during the daytime now that the sun's out.
Same.
Why don't we just destroy the roofs?
That sounds like a great idea.
I have a nice explosive way to do that.
So when we finish our long... is our long rest finished now?
Yeah.
Okay, and it's like just about afternoon, sun is high.
Yeah, it's just about afternoon, Sun is completely high in the sky.
Hold on, I'm gonna roll my d20 first.
Oh yeah.
20-foot radius. Man,
is this when I freaking bust radius. Out? Is this when I bust out by daylight like a fucking god?
20-foot radius.
What's the command?
In brackets, d20.
Hey, look, we solve all of our problems with 5 fireballs. Oh wait, no, 6.
Fireball. For reference.
Huh?
That's a fireball for reference.
Yeah. We're drawing.
Oh, you're drawing over there. Oh, okay. I wasn't thinking that part of the map.
They're over there.
Damn, really? See how many fireballs would it take to cover every single area?
6-6, we'll be fine.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure all of these buildings would burn. I'm pretty sure fire
I think
is like a serious problem back in Kangoo Land.
So it's kind of ironic that you're bonded with this fire spirit?
Yeah, I guess. That might be one reason why they wouldn't like me, although I suspect they have plenty of other reasons to not do that as well. Right. Would you like a death ward?
What?
Nothing.
What are you all doing? You finished your rest.
Preparing.
Chewing on my necklace.
Alright.
So, it's been a while since I've woken up these armlets of the dragon. Do they still have ice damage? Lightning damage?
Yes, you have not changed them yet, I believe.
Okay.
Dude, we get to burn down a village without being the bad guys. That's crazy.
That's crazy.
That's fucking crazy.
Guiding Bolt sounds like a great way to fuck someone's life over.
I'm sure that you can understand every wizard has always wanted to burn down a village. Unfortunately, there is a shortage of villages that need burning down.
I'm glad you can kick that off your bucket list. I look at the village. I look all the way past that to the river. The fateful river, where it all began.
Where it all began.
Okay. Are we really committing to just burning every single tent at once?
It's your village.
Yeah,
it is your village.
I mean, I'm not against the burning it part. I can't really have any attachment when nobody is here except weird demonic bird people. I just wonder if they know if they're sentient.
Do you want to try talking to them?
I was hoping we could capture one first and then talk to them, but I'm not sure if that's feasible.
Well, if you want to do that, you should do it before I start fireballing.
I think we would require us to wait and see if any of them leave the place, but I don't think you have the patience for that.
How about we go up to one and talk to it?
Alright, well, I'm gonna sit over here and have my fireball ready.
Yeah.
You wanna try to talk to the creature?
I guess.
It ain't fab! It ain't my village.
Okay, that's true. That's true. Faf, what do you think? Should we burn this village down with all of them inside?
Faf went into their house.
Wait, how many creatures are there? I thought there was just one.
No, there is a bunch, apparently. Oh, a village is worth, you can even say. Not really. It's a lot less than a village, but a lot more than one.
How about we minor illusion? See if any of them respond. And yeah, then we'll know if they're...
Can any of you speak bird?
You can.
Yeah, I don't know minor illusion.
It has a range of 30 feet.
Yeah. I also don't know if they can see minor illusion inside. I mean, I guess they could. They saw Faf. Maybe we could lure one out?
With a fireball.
No, I think that will alert all of them.
Oh, you got a point.
Now, that would be fine if we were just going in there to kill all of them. Which, I may still be up for that, but I'd like to see if they're sentient first.
Okay, let's go talk to them.
Let's see... I currently can't suggest Faf to me. Bay. That sounds like a terrible idea. But maybe
how about we both go, and I will have
minor illusion, and I'll speak bird.
Minor illusion does not move. Like, minor illusions are static images, and also it has a range of 30 feet.
Well, what if you make a noise that convinces them to come out instead?
Well, how about I just throw a rock at one of these huts?
I guess that's, I've definitely done that before in my earlier days. That's an option.
I enjoy non-magical solutions.
Okay, I throw a rock.
Okay, which one?
I don't know, the closest one that someone says there's a thing in.
This one. This All one? Of these circular ones have ones. I think this one's better. It's closer to that.
Okay, yeah, so we meander around to that edge and I throw a rock.
Okay, move to where you are.
I think we're here. Probably in the trees or some shit.
Okay. Are all of you in the trees?
Is Scam here?
I'm in a tree.
Dude, Annie's been real quiet.
I'm in a tree.
Hello, Scam. Are you here?
Hello.
Do you know what's happening?
No, never. I am
Don't
a tree.
Make this... Good.
I am the tree.
Also, Dave is like off the map. I'm not sure if he wants
Dave
that
can
to
be
happen.
Behind and stuff if you wish it. Get
okay,
line of sight still.
I'm certain that that there's not just an empty void beyond that line. I'm sure.
Yeah.
So.
Okay. <All right. laughs> And so Tess is throwing a rock at this here.
Yeah. I don't know if there's like a window or something. It's like...
No
yeah,
window,
whatever.
The door is on the other side. You're just throwing it at the tent at the moment.
Oh. Huh. Yeah. Sure.
Okay.
It's not really hard.
Drop. Clack, clack, clack.
I guess it probably really won't want to come out during the day, though.
The tent rustles a bit, but then nothing. Like, nothing comes out of it.
Can you...
Plan B.
You see for a moment a black cloak come out from underneath the tent.
Dave. Ooh, what if we lure it out?
Can you mage hand just lift the tent?
Mage hand lift the tent?
what if we lure it out?
Minor illusion can make sounds too.
What? Yeah, that's what I was saying. You can
minor illusion
Yeah, that's what I was
sounds.
Saying! I was gonna tongue in minor illusion.
And it's also time to sing the song of my people.
What if we just lure it out with, like, food, you know?
I would normally suggest that. I would normally suggest that, but I'm not sure what they eat anymore.
Well, clearly they eat bird.
Well...
Sorry, Fab.
I think they also
eat
deer.
They also eat deer.
Because they like raw meat.
Hey, guess what I'm made of.
You know, Dave, there are smarter and safer ways to do this.
Oh, damn.
I was suggesting going there. Anyway, I can use my mage hand. Oh.
You're gonna mage hand lift the tent and then I throw another rock at it?
Yeah, sure. The mage hand can exert a force of like 10 pounds or something. So.
You can at least lift some of the tarp, if that's what you're trying to do.
Oh.
Okay. Your mage hand goes, streaks out across the ground and lifts the tarp up a bit, and you can see black miasma start billowing out. You can see the beak poke out again and like start ruffling and try almost a tongue lather down, tries to grab anything on the other side.
I throw another rock at it.
So maybe you should cast light on the rock that we throw.
I think that's magical darkness, but...
Try it. It's fucking free, dude.
Alright, fine. I light it up first before it's thrown.
Okay, you light it up and throws. With Tessa's aim, you can crack it right into its beak. And the light spills into, like, shining away some of the darkness. And the creature becomes noticeably, you know, shook. Yeah, it didn't like that. It doesn't like it. You see it back away a bit. Yeah, it like backs away from the light, which and the darkness almost goes with the creature a bit.
I don't think it's getting lured out.
Wow, it must really not like the light, huh?
The tent is shaking at the moment as it's like getting pissed off, and it's like you see its tongue reach out, grab the rock, and then fucking take it into its mouth.
It just ate it.
Yeah.
Neat. You know, I could just cast Firebolt and light the tent on fire.
Yeah, I mean, I'm leaning towards that plan. No,
you don't want to talk to them.
We still haven't tried about that part. I forgot that part.
All right.
What are you gonna talk to?
Allow me to sing the song of my people. I think we have like an anthem or some shit.
Okay.
It's something about how kangaroos are great.
Kangaroos are great.
Woo!
I start singing the song of the Kenku in bird.
From that tree?
I squawk in the background.
Maybe from another tree?
I'm just wondering. Okay, so you sing the anthem of the Kenkus from that tree.
No, here's fine.
Alright. To the rest of you, it's an Auron, which sounds very much like a bunch of bird screeches, right? Does not sound enjoyable. Give me a performance check.
Wow. I wasn't exactly great at this. Wow, that's not ominous in any way whatsoever.
You call out and the shrieking, and then you see the tent around you rustle again. This tent rustles. And yeah, we're going into it. They're alerted. Everyone roll initiative.
Oh. Can we leave?
Yeah.
I just wanted to see if it worked.
It did put you on the track.
Interesting.
Even though your macro seems quite yellow.
Where's the tracker?
The tracker's on the left for me.
Oh.
Window initiative. The top left, hit window, and then...
Yeah, I see it.
Window initiative. How do I move this? To here.
Okay, you should have an initiative button on your token.
How do I toggle it to auto hide? Oh, there we go. Where is it? Wow, they hit everything.
Auto hide?
Oh, I put the window in a really weird place.
Okay, while you're figuring that out, I'm gonna... Let's see. Annie, you here?
Yes.
Alright. People are fighting shit. Rolling.
No, I'm not.
I rolled.
I'm down to leave.
Nice.
I rolled bad.
I'm down to leave. How do I roll for initiative?
I rolled for you. Perfect. Works out.
Yeah.
And then I need to roll for this thing. Boop.
This Boop. Thing? Oh no.
Okay, pretty bad. But you do see all of them like shriek out, and even as much as they hate the light, they do hear something that resounds within them, something that brings out primordial instinct, and you see out of these tents come these matted black fur and flesh creatures of distorted forms. Give you a view of the whole map real quick. You see that, and from each of the tents you see this.
Oh no!
Come out.
Oh my.
Observe them.
And
wait a minute, that's a lot of things. I don't like that.
Are they all have less than full HP?
Yes. They seem all like a little disgruntled, limbered, and like decayed in places. They don't seem like in their right health. And all of them also, the black smoke that comes off them that stick to them within the tank starts dissipating, and they all get smaller.
Oh. What is this? Yeah.
Oh, they're cute.
Wait
now.
A minute.
They're cute.
They were so scary, point, and I was like, you just strike them down.
These are still, like, bigger than each of you.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's so funny, though.
That's okay.
That's okay.
Are they. Smaller. Are they. Yeah?
Are they saying anything? I don't have tongues on!
Are they saying anything? You tell
like
me!
A mad raven cawing.
I don't speak bird!
Is it
it's not
understandable?
No, it's literally
a translation.
Of like a territorial bird.
I
need the Google Translate.
The Google Translate is... if I had to translate this, it'd be gibberish. I don't think they're sentient.
Is that a declaration of war or,
yeah, open fire.
Okay.
That's not good.
Or we can leave and do it slowly, but I have a feeling you're not into that. I have a feeling you really want to burn down this village.
I ask my fairy how they're feeling about, trying to mind link with these things and see if they are sentient.
Things?
I just want to point out there are two possible fireballs that catch four things. And one of them catches four things and two buildings. So.
Well, Fweet, it seems to be like wariness, but not like if you think it's the right idea, it's supporting it.
Well. Do you want to try and find out what happened to them? You know? Mm-hmm. Because this is Swallow's place and Swallow's
certainly,
people, so...
I'm gonna say this much. Talking hasn't worked. If you think talking to them in their minds will work, go for it. But regular talking has not
All
worked.
Alright, vibe check.
Okay, vibe check on the nearest one?
Yeah.
Okay,
do I need to be closer? What's the range? What's the range? Is it what I can see, or...?
Leave it. We'll just.
Fuck, it's so fucking far.
Yeah, it's 50 feet away from me.
Where is 30? Let's see. Alright. Hello! Vibe check!
Okay, as you come towards it, it calls out in your direction, and as you vibe check it, you get. Emotion after emotion after emotion that like cycles on itself. Pain, hunger, pain, food, pain, living creature, pain, eat. Like it's a cycle of like a very low intelligence animal that's focused on its needs, but every so often there's just a raw emotion of pain.
That is unusual for an animal to have.
Yeah.
Like a level of awareness.
It's on repeat, on just like the sentient thought of like pain, it's painful, breaking, body, pain, like every so often.
Guys, I hate to break this to you, but I think they're sentient.
Uh-oh.
What do you mean?
Just saying.
What do you mean?
So you want us to like not kill them?
No.
I mean,
I look over at Swallow.
We've killed a lot of sentient things, I'm just saying.
I am not sure what you mean by they're sentient.
Are
they intelligent?
You had enough time to convey that much.
Can I try and ask it what it is and who it is?
Sure, in its mind, what do you ask?
Who are you? What happens to you?
As you try and probe at the sentience, at its sense of personality, you see it's washed away by this continual cycle of emotion, right? It seems to be like pain, and then attention turns to you, right? Food? Pain! Food? Where? Like, as it's trying to find you, and it is very much similar to like a dumb animal, except every so often it's that sentient part of its mind repeating its pain as if it's drowned in that madness.
Okay.
Is that it?
I guess that's all I can do for now.
Alright, Swallow, you're up.
Huh. Well, is there any... I'm gonna think, is there any instances where... Is this like a reversible thing? It feels like it's pretty fucked, right?
You can do a check of your choosing. Arcana, religion, whatever kind you wish, to try and gather some information. Marshall is also apparent in this fight.
I'm gonna give it a Marshall check. We'll see, maybe I can glean some information off of this. It's insight.
Okay, that works. There is also a Marshall button right in this next initiative, but the creature that I'll be naming Shrieker from now on is very much some horrible experiment that its body seems ill-equipped to contain. It has a number of abilities, which you get from the Marshall check for free, the names of. It has the following. Caw, peck, regurgitate, and gather murder. In addition, this definitely seems like an undead experimentation of some sort. You would need magic of quite a degree to try and reverse it. The possibility does exist, as it was mentioned before, that Flea's Emerald might have the capability, as well as spells of like, you have Greater Restoration yet? No, right?
No.
Yeah, it's something on that level.
Let's see. I'm in the mind to just okay. If it is reversible, I think it's time to rethink this. It's time to leave. Let them feed, I guess. But I would like to not be food. Right, so you say something like Greater Restoration or the Emerald might do something.
Yes, that's the two things that comes to mind.
I turn around and like, so how prepared are you guys to capture one?
I mean, I am, for the most part, physical melee, so I can control my blows usually. But I think some of our spellcasters might be harder.
I can probably morph one of them into a dumb idiot, and then we can put him in a bucket.
Yeah, I'm thinking if it's possible that we can potentially grab one and cure it, we might be able to gain more information on what the hell happened here.
Well, we've already got all their attention. I don't...
Well, in that case, What's the chance you think we can polymorph one of these and run?
Yeah, why not? I can polymorph one of them into a dumb idiot. That'll work. Probably. Maybe.
Yeah, so what do you want the plan to be like?
You don't have time to think this all out. Are you doing anything else?
Alright. Yeah, it is time to help people do that by blessing them and then leaving.
Okay, who are you blessing?
I bless the people who need to be involved in this operation. Tess, Dave, I'm gonna bless Flea because she's probably gonna get jumped on.
What does Bus even do?
D4 to attack rolls and saving throws.
Oh, well, that doesn't help me.
It doesn't, but maybe you're gonna get jumped.
If you need to make a concentration check, it helps.
That is true.
Also that.
Alright, that's true.
Alright, are you staying there, Swallow?
No.
Alright. Hop down, scurry on.
Alright.
Dave, you go.
Let's turn the close one into a dumb idiot.
Okay, what kind of saving throw is this again?
Wisdom for some reason.
Okay, what kind of dumb idiot is it turning into?
I don't know, a snail?
Something small.
A snail, a really brightly colored snail, so we don't lose it though.
Okay, it turns into a very brightly colored snail as it drops onto the ground.
Obnoxious neon pink snail, bet.
Yes, and it's an obnoxious neon pink snail.
Okay. Oh, okay.
It's an obnoxious neon pink snail right there.
Nice. That's cool.
That's cool.
I'm sure someone else can do the running.
Yeah, it's gonna be dust.
Because I do not have enough fast for this. I guess I'll turn on Blade Song in case I get, like, smacked or something somehow.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. It.
You are hymning, rhyming, what, fucking humming to yourself. We move on to Tess.
I use key to cast the speed thing, Step of the Wind.
Okay.
And I just snatch him up and wail him out.
Okay, so it is. How much movement do you have? You have 45 feet, so easy enough to get to him, pick him up, and fucking run back.
Yeah, and I think if that's my
just your bonus movement. Action and your
bonus action, movement, and I don't know, if I'm not doing anything else, I can just use the rest of my action to run.
Dip.
Okay.
Alright, let's haul ass!
So Tess
is haul ass.
Further just running for it. She is 45 feet that direction.
I'm lifting the snail above my head as like a bright pink beacon. Like, YOLO.
We're leaving.
Look, if we're not fireballing, we're running.
Okay. Yeah. Scam, it's your turn.
Scam, don't do this. We're leaving.
What do you mean, don't do this? What do you mean, don't do this?
Never mind. Do what you think is correct.
You see in the distance.
Yeah.
You can make the snail the pet. You see in the distance a bright pink snail being waved.
I would like to obtain bright pink snail. How do I obtain?
You follow the bright pink snail being waved above Tess's head.
I follow bright pink snail. Where pink snail man?
Okay, you run over to Tess and catch up.
I pet the pink snail. I'm tempted to eat it. I don't know why.
Would you like to eat it?
Yeah.
Please no.
Definitely, I mean, very much keep it out of your grasp.
Yeah, I mean, I'll definitely try, but like, you know, it's possible. Scam might be able to do it.
I think if Scam eats it, the Scam dies. The straight dies.
Scam, if you want to try and grapple for it, you can give an athletic check. Tess can give an acrobatic check.
Yes. Oh, by the way, my checks are gone. I don't know where they are.
Oh, do you have the selected menu or no? There's a window that says selected. Go to top left. It says window.
I'm done.
I'm about to roll for you.
Oh, wait, not without. No.
Athletics.
Yeah, I'm not really that good at that, to be honest.
That's pretty good. There is a
chance. That's a good roll, considered.
Bad luck.
Okay.
Feels bad. Not my pink snail meal! Damn it, my snack!
Whew, just, well, I mean, should, if it, I should still roll in case I roll a one, right?
No, if you need to
be. No, one will win.
Okay,
so
okay.
You just need a one, so you barely keep it out of.
I just barely keep it out of the skin.
You see a fucking timeline of everything going wrong, Scam biting down on this little snail, it exploding in his mouth.
There is nothing wrong. I'm hungry. I know I had fish, but that's not enough anymore. Pink snail? Rare delicacy.
I'm literally watching this like, oh my fucking god, we didn't think this one through.
Alright, give me one.
Delicious.
Test. We go to there.
Delicious. I see no issues with this. I'm hungry.
Mm-hmm.
I think snail, good meal.
Scam, stop it.
Okay.
What?
Since we're going off
but
the
it's
map,
pink.
Let me just grab something.
Delicious.
No.
Yes.
No.
Have you ever had snail before? I feel like you would have as a bird.
Yes, I have, but it's not the point.
Yes. I should eat snail too.
Damn, really pulling this map back out. Wow, the river really got a lot larger down there.
The transformation lasts for the duration or until the target drops to 0 hit points or dies.
Yeah.
Scam literally fucking explodes and dies. I don't really...
I drool while looking at the
snail. Even after ascending into demi-divinity, some things just don't change.
Hey, I mean, this is what, you know, my divine powers of manipulating luck are for.
Keeping people from making terrible decisions.
I drool looking at the snail.
You're trying your best, I say.
Good enough. Alright, that's where you guys are. Their turn. They all will shriek out and move forward. Let's do the snail first. Snail tries to hit Tess. It misses.
What does that even look like?
It tries to headbutt Tess with its
fucking... It tries to headbutt Tess and pulls it away.
Can we make it a hit, please?
It hits and deals 0 damage. Because that's negative strength. These creatures are going to... You see them try to flap their wings, try to reach into the air, and they just get hurtled down. It almost looks like as they're moving, them slightly getting sent down. Lift down, lift down. They're running forward.
Man, you know Kenkus are not supposed to be able to fly, right?
And they still
can't. Wait, you can fly?
No, I cannot! That's the problem here. That's kind of like
calling you for rides
for
all the time.
We have hands, not wings.
The fuck, man?
Okay, that is their base movement.
Kind of lame.
And now, Fui.
Hey. I saw something like this coming.
Actually, where is this one? It was like here.
35, I think.
Thank you. Boom. Like here.
That one's right.
This one's right or no?
Further down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Good shit. Let me do this. Okay. So, you see, we'll start with this one here. It is going to... you see its, like, throat undulating and then... Oh, no, wait. You can't do that. Fuck. Shit.
It eats it back up.
This guy comes here. This guy comes down there. Runs up there. Runs up here. Here. There. 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 Okay, that's the end of their turn, using their action to dash. Do they have a bonus action? Nope, they do not. Boom. Wait, it's your turn. You're surrounded.
Wow.
You can just pass. You can just pass. You'll be fixed. It's fine.
Are you dimension dooring?
Dimension door?
I was also thinking I could just misty step out.
Oh, right. You have that.
Alright, that's cheaper.
Goodbye, my friends.
That is cheaper.
Okay. 30 feet is the range.
Yeah, well, I think we're all running.
So, I'm gonna misty step into right here behind them. High and swallow.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. We're all
and I'm giving the three of us fly.
Oh, I mean, you don't need to give me fly.
You can't because you've cast Misty Step. You cannot cast an action spell on bonus actions.
I keep forgetting about that.
You're going on foot. You're going on foot. It's fine. I will summon swords.
I'll fucking run then.
You just start fly out of there.
I really don't like that role. It's just like so unintuitive.
Movement and action, right? That's what I have.
Yeah, movement and action.
So I can just go like
run 60 feet. Wow, these forest maps really come out of nowhere, huh?
We're doing our best.
It really is so unintuitive. I hate it. Mm-hmm. I keep forgetting
it's about only that. For bonus action spells, too, so it's like really weird.
Yeah. It's just like not even that many spells it applies to, but like.
I use like
half. It's always like kind of gotcha when you think you can do that, but you can't.
Yeah. It's my turn now?
Is Fui doing anything else?
Oh, I just booked it.
Alright, Twala, you're up.
Hey, Dave, you're gonna be fine, right?
You're gonna be fine.
Yeah, if you're just gonna run,
I can literally just walk away.
Okay.
I think they run faster than you.
I run at 40, I'll be fine.
Oh, they run at 50.
Surely I'll be fine.
I get on my sword, and I fly up.
Okay, you fly on up.
I fly up 30 feet. And I fly up another 30 feet, and I'm just gonna be like, yeah, so I'm gonna attract their attention. You guys keep moving.
Okay, so you're straight up 60 feet.
Yeah, I'm straight up 60 feet, and I'm making a lot of noise. I'm still singing the anthem of my people.
I'd give that a 5 out of 10.
Alright. Dave, you're up.
We're not. Where's Faf?
Faf is just flying was away. In this tree and he's like, yeah, fuck this shit.
Yeah, good thinking. Do you know Faf does not take opportunity attacks?
He does not, he has flyby.
That's crazy.
Okay, yeah, we're gonna walk. Dragon breath tactic.
We're gonna walk 40 feet away and then another 40 feet away. I don't know. Is the distance accurate between the two maps?
Sure. Yes. Right. Actually, let's do this real quick and then it'll be accurate.
Alright, I am up 60 feet.
Delicious.
I'm up 60 feet and I'm hoping that I have their attention. I'm also suspecting that they have range attacks. I'm about to get fucked, but don't worry about it.
Okay, it is Tess, your turn.
Hi! Are they still chasing after us?
Yeah.
I'll just keep pulling arse then, just...
Okay, you are just booking it. Are you spending any more key or no?
Nah, I think it's a bit too late to hide from them.
Okay.
I was gonna do I mean, I don't think they can catch up, right, with just their base distance.
So they have to keep dashing, which they theoretically could, but I'm hoping that if I can keep their attention on me long enough, you guys can leave. And since I can fly, I can just fly away.
If they want to keep dashing in the sun, that's fine for them.
Yep.
Yeah. All right. So Tess makes it there without issue, just running. Scam, what are you doing?
Vibing with the snail.
Okay, you want to go for the snail again?
No. They didn't let me get in.
Actually, to catch up to Tess now, you would need to use bonus action as well. Unfortunate, but you do catch up using everything.
I'm desperate. Give me the snail. There is nothing wrong here.
Hey, can you high five me as you pass?
Yeah. High five. Wait. Not the hand with the snail.
Yeah. High five.
Max the snail for one damage.
Yeah. High five one damage.
Infamous snail has one health. Turns back into Big Bird.
All right.
Or dies.
Give me a performance check, Swallow.
Oh my, not another one.
I say woo from far away while Swallow's
doing the performance.
Woo! I give that half a star out of 10.
Wow, I think I really struggle with multitasking.
I would give that on a scale from 1 to 20 a 2.
Wow, they really want your bitch ass.
Going for the closest target that's within reach. Yeah.
Okay, I have a plan B, guys.
Yeah?
But they used everything to get there. Fui.
Which means they can still attack of opportunity.
Yeah. These four can attack opportunity you.
Oh my god, I should have fucking
You can also just stand still and, like, be instantly taken 500 feet away from here.
Sure. I will stand right here and cast fucking fairy fire on the fucking lot of them.
Oh shit, okay.
Dang.
What saving throw is that?
Sorry?
What kind of saving throw?
Dex.
It is dexterity.
Dex.
Okay. Dexterity. It's a
20 feet,
so...
I was about to cast
that catches literally all of them.
Oh my god, if it got to me, but that seems a little excessive.
Okay,
well, shit.
Wow. High rolls.
That one fails. We'll put this on them. Okay, this one...
They don't like sunlight. How about some more fucking light?
They are glowing now and very much not having
unhappy with it.
Am I glowing?
I do have to make this
save. It's not optional.
Oh wait.
I mean, I could aim it this way. It's a 20-foot cube, so it doesn't have to catch
her.
You.
She can put it somewhere else.
Where is it? I want to be glowing. I feel it.
Dave is now glowing.
This is a classic Black Sat party trick.
Do I have to make a fucking throw? I'm in
Are
it.
Are you putting it on yourself? Then yes.
Well, I mean, it's a cube, right? It affects the area?
Yeah.
Does that include myself?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay.
If you want to catch Dave, yourself, you have to
Honestly, I think you glowing might be a good thing. Maybe. Although, if you want to fail it, you have bless.
Okay, you do not fail it. You are not glowing.
Also, Dave also has bless.
Yeah,
I guess
purposely
you
failing.
To fail it.
I chose to fail it.
Okay.
You can choose to fail it.
What color am I?
Now, all around you is black matted fur glowing with the sprinkled fire, and they're all like almost looking at it themselves and are trying to get away from each other as well as their own skin.
Haha, that's very brave.
You're right.
I don't think they're raving for the sake of entertainment.
I'm gonna turn around and reach my hand out for Dave. Dave, help me!
I fly up to 90 feet, and then I move 30 feet, and I'm still singing.
Okay. You got the... And if you're that far away, they're not gonna be hearing you. If you're 90 feet in the air.
I can move. I move my sword with a bonus action. I use my movement. I can use my action still.
Yeah.
I'm still singing.
Okay. You will have to stay at that 60 feet elevation to still have enough, you know, be close enough
okay.
to... You, so you're not complete... Like, if you're even if you're shouting, right? 60 feet is, like, the vocal range.
Alright, I'm gonna be here-ish 60 feet up, then.
Okay. Dave. Fweez outstretches her hand, ready as these things are, like, trying to gnaw at her.
Hello? Alright, and then we're gonna go 500 feet to the, south?
Out of combat.
Yeah, why not?
All four of you are basically out of combat now. Alright, Tess is out of combat, Scam's out of combat. These things fucking see you guys vanish and are like trying to get away from themselves. They fucking start fanning out, some of them. Give me a performance check, Swallow.
Woo! Party!
I feel like performance checks have not been good recently.
Party time.
You're welcome. I mean, what?
Wow, okay. I'm really bad at this.
Catch the attention of two of them, and the rest fan out and leave your line of view as they go running off in other directions. We are out of combat, so Swall, what do you want to do at these two of these are like looking up at you, like screeching and whatnot? Oh, wait a minute, let me check something. No, you're good. Yeah, keep going.
Show's over. Thank you for your patronage. Goodbye.
You fly off? How fast do you fly?
I could keep using everything I have to fly.
How fast?
Everything. I use my bonus action movement.
I need a speed, motherfucker.
That's a 90 feet.
90 feet? Okay, yeah. You outpace them. As they start running after you at first, but then, you know, you lose them behind and eventually lose sight of all of them. Alright.
I catch up to them. And where are we?
You are in a clearing quite a ways away.
I don't think we're really out of combat. We have one more thing to take care of.
You're out of combat for at least until you do damage for an hour.
Yeah. Alright, guys, so how are we keeping this thing here? Actually, Dave, can you like make a bubble and we keep it in the bubble?
It doesn't stop things from coming out, right?
Shit.
Yeah.
Shit.
I mean, we can't keep it here.
Well, actually, maybe there's magic circle. Do I have a magic circle scroll? I might. I need to check my inventory. I'll do that as soon as I find the inventory sheet. Party notes. I think I might have a magic circle scroll.
What if you had, like, a party of a sufficient number of wizards to, like, encase it in Liamon's tiny huts? It's not in any of the tiny huts, but the, like, the combined exteriors of it create, like, a little box for it.
Alright, so I do not have a magic circle scroll, nor do I have that spell prepared, nor do I think I even learn it. It might be a level 5 spell.
Funny enough that you have that idea, Dave.
What?
With your keen mind, you remember a magic item you have.
What? I know I have the golden script dagger, but I don't know if I have anything else that's useful.
Mm-hmm.
What am I going to do with that?
What does it do?
It lets me cast a ritual spell.
Can you cast multiple tiny huts?
How many charges does it have?
You can basically store a spell at the beginning of the day, which spell you want to be able to, like, cast.
Yeah, but, like, how many times do I get to do it?
Unlimited. You just choose that spell for the day.
It was unlimited?
Yeah, you choose a spell for
the day. It's unlimited?
Yes. You choose a spell for the day, and then throughout that whole day, you can cast that spell without, instead of 10 extra minutes, 6 extra seconds.
Oh, that's interesting. Well, this still doesn't really work, because I need to be inside of the hut each time.
Oh.
So I don't think the geometry works. I don't think it works.
That's interesting.
Good thinking. Good thinking.
I did not have magic circle prepared. I cannot.
Yeah, I guess I would have put. I have to choose one spell. I thought it was like
it
multiple spells.
Three.
I don't remember what the actual.
It's three.
Exact text of it was. I was looking for it actually. I don't want to like interrupt to ask though.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, I think I remember three as well. So we'll say three.
Okay.
Three spells. Okay.
I'm about to use this rope of mending to fucking tie it up.
It's a snail. How do you tap a snail?
Maybe after it grows bigger, but it also
do we have something that will just like make him unconscious right after? I mean, otherwise, like we unturn him and then I attempt a stunning strike.
We could knock him out, I guess. You can knock him out
or something. Yeah, I don't know.
But I think the main issue is that
we beat him up until he's knocked out.
It might die from being exposed to sunlight. I think that's the biggest problem. So we need to choose
somewhere.
I pick
up a leaf and put it over its head.
It's going to be a little larger than that.
What if I offer my billowing cloak?
Well, actually, once we knock it out, we could immediately put darkness over it, right?
Am I actually hexed or is it just testing things?
I was taking off the other mark. Because bless is faded.
Well, I think
can I make it slightly overcast so we're not directly in the sun using my orb?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. What are you doing to the orb?
I don't know. I'm just like
a floating ball of darkness as an umbrella.
Yeah, sure. I don't know. Like,
are you concentrating on that effect, or are you doing anything physically to the orb itself?
I'm just sort of concentrating.
I think we should wait first, right? Because it grows larger when it's in darkness.
Well, I was just gonna make it like a little, like, you know, overcast, but still bright.
Yeah, but you can't move it, right?
I mean, do you want... I don't know what you're trying to do here.
I was thinking maybe we knock it out first, and then we, like, make the umbrella.
Well, how are we gonna knock it out? Well, I mean, I thought your worry was, like, if we undo it and then it's in direct sunlight, it's gonna die while we try to knock it out.
Before we think too much about that, Polymorph does not change its mind in any way, so if we can just talk to it in snail form.
Oh.
Alright, I hold it out. Sorry, it might be a little squish.
Do I have the clairvoyance still prepared? I think I do.
Hello?
Yeah, can I
tongue it? I don't think it has the requisite body parts.
Yeah. Alright, Fui. Or have you decided on your name yet?
Maybe I should have turned it into an animal that can, like, make sound.
Alright, Fui, are you down to delve into the mind of a creature that is feral?
Well, I already sort of did.
Well, yeah, but now I'm going with you so we can suffer together.
Look to my fairy, okay.
There's a difference between going into my head and soul. Clairvoyance is trying to go into the soul, keep that in mind.
That might be good too, actually. We already checked the mind wasn't looking too hot either. The soul is still the same if it's a snail, right?
Yeah, it doesn't.
I can cast. Yo, I can cast sending to the snail. Hello.
I will say, from what you understood from Fui's mind link with it, this creature is not conversable mentally because of most of its, you know, things are raw animalistic instincts in addition to just a sentient mind that is taken up completely by the madness of pain.
Okay. I'm gonna ask Fui. Okay, let's go check out its soul, seeing that nothing else has worked so far. I cast clairvoyance.
Would speak with animals, Cal?
Speak with animals will let you speak. Your mind link already lets you do that, basically. This is the same thing as mind link in terms of communicating with it. But in its current state of this experimental thing, it's you don't get much communication out of it.
Yeah. I am casting clairvoyance.
Look to my fairy.
Okay.
I think he dealt with it.
Clairvoyance is being cast, and y'all are delving the fuck in.
Well, is it all of us? So
well,
just
you two. Is there anyone else trying to go along?
I'm kind of busy right now, concentrating on some, you know, keeping him in snail form.
I'm focused on trying to obtain the snail for my next meal.
Scam, please don't. Scam, please don't.
I've tried, but Tess keeps taking it away from me.
All right, Scam. Let me explain to you what happens if you hate the snail. You'll bite down on the snail, and then it will turn into a large bird while you're eating it, completely destroying your jaw and probably your skull, and then killing it.
Oh. I still want a taste, though. Can I lick it at least?
Please, do not. We'll find a different snail.
It's not the same.
It will be the same if Dave casts Polymorph on it again.
Still not the same.
I'm going in. Don't let him eat the snail.
I'm gonna follow Swallow now.
My
conquest for the snail has failed.
Swallow. So you wanna go into the snail's soul? Can Scam go into the snail's soul with me?
How are you trying to get him to go with you?
Can he use the magic rock of magicness?
Does Scam know how to use a magic rock?
Do you want
Scam
to
knows
the
nothing.
Rock, Scam?
Scam tries to chew on the magic rock.
Okay. You chew on it, you hear it think, you feel a sense of disembodiment. But whether or not you're willing yourself forward is up to you.
I allow myself to look into the snail.
Alright, he's going with me. He's going with
bardic
me.
Bardic inspiration before we do this. Can I just bardic inspiration us?
Sure.
Yeah, sure. Go for it.
Scam, your body falls down as you stay standing, biting onto your rock. You're a natural projection now.
You know, this feels very
I
familiar.
I try to kick my body.
You try to wipe your body?
I try to kick my body.
Yeah, your foot
hey, why is it not working? Why isn't he waking up? Hey, wait a minute.
That's you!
this feels very familiar. Kick Swallow. Why is this happening again?
I try to kick Swallow. Hey, why isn't this working either? What the hell, man?
They cannot see or hear you as you just kick through his body.
I make goofy faces.
Oh, by the way, Tess, now if you have your eye on and looking at your party at the moment, you do see you see something you didn't see previously, and you see a large figure enveloping Flea. So you can see this at all times when you have the eye open next to Flea now.
I'm just ignoring that.
Okay.
You see, it's like my friend, you know, I'm like turning around talking to it, nothing to worry about. And I was like, this is not my problem.
I'm going into the soul. Who's diving with me?
Alright, Fui, are you going in?
If my fairy doesn't... You know what? I hold its hands, you know, its approximation of a hand.
Uh-huh.
Let's go.
Alright, you're taking the fairy with you, or you're leaving it with your body?
I'm gonna take it with me.
Okay. Dave and Tess are just babysitting outside.
Laval.
Well, I have to concentrate on keeping the snail in snail form.
Yeah.
So, I don't think I can go inside.
I'm the bodyguard. Do I have to bardic inspiration 4 times?
You can.
I think she means for her friend.
Oh, wait, repeat that? Oh, are you... If you want to inspire your friend.
Yeah.
That
counts as an extra one, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
Alright. You all... Swallow concentrates, closing his eyes on the spell, and as he does, you see a glint of magic from the ruby emanate from him towards this little snail-like creature that's still, like, trying to get out of Tessa's grasp. Will you mind,
hey,
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Jakar, if things go wrong, like, pull me back.
Alright, I'll be your tether.
Yeah, you'd be pulling everyone else back with me, right?
Maybe the girl, but I don't think I can pull that one back unless he wants to come, because it's not going through.
Ooh!
This is weird. This is like solar travel, so it's gonna open like a gate, okay? I can keep the gate open so you can run back through it, but, you know, like...
Oh my god, scale!
Don't leave those two behind. Alright?
I try to make spooky noises, not knowing that people can't actually hear me.
I'm literally going to grab their wrists and drag them back with me. That's the plan.
Alright, well, I'll keep the gate open as long as I can. Just be careful.
Alright. Okay, we're going.
I continue making spooky noises like that. Like that contributes anything. Ooh.
You all dive into this creature, right? Feeling your energies and souls shift into them. And you appear. Here. Into what appears a barren scape of what might have once been a jungle, but everything is dead, dying. Trees are withered, rocks, places.
Jesus Christ, Sirak sure is fucked up.
And it is devoid of life and feeling, with just a trinkle of energies left. And before you, you see the form of this creature, like in the ground, almost chained in place. Oops, not that.
Wow, Shika 8 has been hexed.
I make funny faces in front of the creature.
Well, you're not there in front of the creature, but you see the creature chained down in front of you.
I still try to make funny faces in front of it.
In the middle of this scape.
Spoopy.
As you look around, you see if Scam is there with you, you see Fuya is there, and this large pink winged entity is right behind Fui as well.
Oh, hey, hello. I think we've met before. Sorry for burning your hand, wing,
it
face
around a bit, like as if, you know, testing this, your ability to see it as your eyes, you know, catch it, and then it goes back and settles behind Fui.
Okay, I understand. All right. Okay, let's get down to business. Okay. Does it?
I try to run towards the creature.
Okay. Scam, jump, run, skip. Runs towards the creature.
I skip around the creature.
Scam, wait, no.
And as you get close to it, Scam, it shrieks out, restrained by these chains that are smoky and in the ground. And as it does, that's where we'll end the session. We'll pick up for the next time.
I see no issues with this. This cannot end badly.
Why are you always out trying to kill yourself?
I am not doing nothing of the sort. I am just exploring.
Scam is expecting to.
I am doing my job.
Okay. Yeah. I don't know if you expected this.
Things happen.
I am doing my job.
That's great.
I don't know if you expected us to kidnap one and then leave.
Did I expect to add 4 maps to the scene? No, I did not.
I mean, I feel like a lot of battle maps just are small. So.
Yeah. But, like, dependent on, like, you know, where you guys would go. So it was pretty good.
Yeah, we were definitely en route to just burn down the village.
Yeah, that's what I assumed would happen.
Yeah, and then we was like, they're sentient guys. It's like, alright, fine.
I would have been fine. I would have been just like, just murder them.
Yeah, but no. Saul,
just put them out of their mercy. Just put them out of their misery.
He's gathering information, quote unquote.
I'm eating information. Yeah. Or trying to eat information. It's a rough job, man. You don't understand.
I don't know. I'm seeing that this creature's inside the soul instead of what I assume to have been a normal Kenku really gives me some doubts on things.
Yeah, I was like,
Huh, so this shrieker is inside the shrieker, not a normal fucking thing inside the shrieker.
Yeah, I'm just like,
I think he's broken.
So I guess we go back and fireball everyone in the end, right?
It's starting to look that way.
I think I'm hungry. I want a snail.
You have not had a good look around. What you have noticed is it's chained down within its own soul for some reason. And I will say, like, even if I was not prepared with the maps, right? This was not completely unexpected because it's built on all the stuff you've done before.
Soul, freaking going to magic school bus, except I'm going to people's souls instead of their bodies.
Yep. And so we'll see how this actually turns out next time.
Next episode
of PNPD.
Wee woo.
Alright. Shit happened. We'll see how things turn out next time.